Ladies and gentlemen, it is time for What is Trending with our digital producer, Trent Gilbert. Trent's at Mouse.
Thank you, CP.
What do you think, Trent? What do you think about, you know, getting rid of cash?
I never carry cash.
I really don't either.
Yeah.
Me too, it just makes it easy. Yeah, the only thing I always feel bad about, and I keep ones in my car, I don't know why I went like that, that's not my car, is for valet.
Yeah,
like you want,
good
you know,
point.
But I think hopefully they're
tipping
even
money.
Getting, yeah, because you want to make sure you tip your valets.
You're right, you're wise.
Okay, all right, what's trending?
Well, you know, so we're all about reboots these days. Will and Grace, Roseanne, et cetera, et cetera. And NBC's Frasier might be next in line.
I loved Frasier.
So it would still star Kelsey Grammer, of course, how could it not? But they're in talks with the studios to maybe bring it back. It might be set in a new city, no more Seattle. But as you can tell, Carrie's very excited about it. Gary actually said, I'm not sure a new series of Frasier is a good idea, but then I thought Frasier wouldn't work as a spinoff from Cheers.
Exactly.
Okay. How many Emmys later, Gary?
Right, Gary.
Come on now.
No,
but
it's
Kiss
so
Drugs.
True.
I don't know why I got mad at you, Gary. Peter Miller tweeted out a couple ideas for the reboot, and obviously they're a little more intense than you'd expect. Space Needle? What?
What?
And this one I didn't really get. Maybe CB can decipher it for me. Sherry Niles, like Sherry, but then I guess there's some sort of alternate reality where Daphne's in a bubble. I don't really know what that means.
I don't know. Is that Daphne? That's
right?
Not Daphne.
Oh, no, it's not?
I don't
Maybe.
Know. Who is that?
Check it out. Right, find the post on our Facebook page. Weigh in the comments. Peter Miller, yeah.
Let's ask Peter Miller. That went
okay,
way over our heads on Thursday.
No. Okay. Tweeted him directly before the show. Sorry I didn't get that for you guys.
No.
But what else we got?
Come on, what else we got?
Okay.
Oh, stand
by. I'm so sorry. Let's see a clip from Frasier. Right near the end of its run. Do you remember Felicity Huffman was a love interest for a very short time?
Yes.
I'm as Desperate Housewives. Let's take a look.
How dare you presume to know the workings of my heart? You can't understand the kind of feelings Julie and I have for one another. You may as well ask me to describe the essence of music or the color of starlight.
Nice towels, Frasier. You'd think a couple of old ladies lived here.
Get out.
That romance ended then and there.
Oh, my gosh.
Wow.
Wow. I would be interested in that. I loved that show.
Yeah. But what would it be like without the dear old dad?
No, I was
rest
just,
in peace.
No, I was just going to say that.
Yeah.
Because he really, his one-liners, his zingers.
Yeah. And you have to have that juxtaposition because they were so.
Yes.
And he's salt of the earth.
I know. I love it. Yeah, well, let's think
that. Speaking of salt of the earth, a corporate uniform, if you will. Now, there's a lot of people in sales that like the fleece vest. I was on the search upstairs. I failed in that mission as well. But the fleece vest. Tweet us at ATL & Co. if your hubby or yourself wears one. But Wall Street Journal did a very in-depth article about just how heinous it is. Let's look at a comment.
Wow.
The article I've been waiting for to explain the proliferation of the fleece vest, the corporate bros uniform, it's inexcusable.
That is a strong statement.
Yeah. You would never be caught dead letting Jim wear
Well, Jim's
a fleece
got
vest.
Great style. Now, he does like the vest, but he, like, in the winter, I notice they're the nicer wool ones, you know.
Why wear a jacket?
Because he gets hot easily.
Oh, okay. So
you've got some air conditioning going on here, but you're warm here.
See, it's a very utility thing.
Yes.
It's very difficult to just sit there and work in a suit jacket. I'd like to sit at my desk and feel a little bit more comfortable.
Exactly.
Okay, Dave, thank you for enlightening us.
Right.
And one more. Let's see one more. Catherine Davis says, there are times where I just can't wear a shirt. I kind of have to wear a vest.
All right.
Okay. Tweet us your opinion at ATL & Co. Thank you so much. I'll be back
next
week.
Let's go shopping for some vests.
Oh, my God.
Okay.
Yes, please.
That was our show for today. If you want to learn more about any of our great guests, head to AtlantaCompany.com. See you back here tomorrow.
Atlanta & Company was brought to you by 50 Floor. And Atlanta & Company set is furnished by Designed Within Reach.